From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Infectious disease expert Dr. Nakia Forbes says changes to the travel requirements revealed yesterday by the Office of the Prime Minister are consistent with data about how COVID-19 variants are affecting the ability of vaccinated people to transmit the virus. Still, she underscored how much vaccination remains a potent shield against a serious case of COVID-19, with no fully vaccinated person admitted to the hospital up to July 31st. In a statement yesterday, the OPM announced all fully vaccinated travelers coming to the country will now be required to obtain a COVID-19 test, that's rapid antigen test or PCR, with a negative result within 5 days of arrival. For unvaccinated travelers, the requirements remain the same. Those 12 years or older must get a PCR test within 5 days of arriving in the country. Further, the OPM said, quote, all children between the ages of 2 and 11 wishing to enter the Bahamas will now be required to obtain a COVID-19 test, rapid antigen test or PCR, with a negative test result within 5 days of arrival in the Bahamas. All children under the age of 2 are exempt from any testing requirements. All travelers entering the Bahamas on a cruise ship will be subjected to the testing requirements mandated by the cruise line and approved by the competent authority. All fully vaccinated travelers wishing to travel within the Bahamas will now be required to obtain a COVID-19 test, rapid or antigen, with a negative result within 5 days of the travel date. This pertains to travel from New Providence, Grand Bahama, Bimini, Exuma, Abaco, and North Eleuthera, including Harbor Island. The 200-meter final in Tokyo, Japan, turned out to be a major disappointment for Shawnee Miller-Weibo as she jogged across the finish line in eighth place. 12 hours after she cruised to first place in the opening round of the 400 meters in her attempt for the 200-400-meter double at the 2020 Olympic Games, Miller-Weibo got left behind coming off the curve. Running in no man's land in lane 9, she couldn't turn on the afterburners on the home stretch and faded behind the pack in a time of 24.00 seconds. Jamaica's Elaine Thompson-Hurrah celebrated with her second consecutive sweep of the two sprint titles as she took the gold in a national record of 21.53. Namibia's Christine Mbama established an under-20 Olympic record in 21.81, and American Gabrielle Thomas clinched the bronze in 21.87. The Bahamian shipping agent for a vessel that offloaded wood waste containing an invasive beetle species yesterday pledged to fight impending customs charges and efforts to make it a scapegoat for the controversy. Albert Hepburn, Elnat Maritime's chief executive, voiced optimism to the Tribune that they'll be exonerated with the right investigation, days after multiple government agencies announced a probe into how the Pan Jasmine cargo ship was able to offload without their approval wood waste infested with an Asian beetle renowned for destroying trees. Promising that the company would fight through it, he said he had passed Bahamas Customs' July 30th letter setting out a list of charges against Elnat Maritime to his attorneys at the Paris Whitaker law firm in readiness for a potential legal battle that could potentially reach the Bahamian courts. The Department of Marine Resources is urging fishermen to abide by fisheries laws as crawfish season opened on August 1st. In a press statement yesterday, the department reminded fishermen that the legal measurement for whole crawfish is a carpus jacket length of 3 1/4 inches, and when the tail is separated, a tail length of 5 1/2 inches. Those wishing to harvest crawfish are also required to have a crawfish measuring gauge in their possession at all times. Possession of dishwashing liquid, bleach, and/or noxious substances aboard any vessel while fishing is unlawful without first obtaining a permit authorizing such possession. Further, a permit is required for use of the air compressor or crawfish traps to aid in fishing. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, an investigation found that Governor Andrew Cuomo sexually harassed nearly a dozen women in and out of state government and worked to retaliate against one of his accusers. New York's Attorney General announced today, hastening calls for the Democrats' resignation or impeachment. The governor remained defiant, saying in a taped response to the findings that the facts are much different than what has been portrayed and that he never touched anyone inappropriately or made inappropriate sexual advances. The nearly 5-month investigation found that Cuomo's administration was a hostile work environment, rife with fear and intimidation. The probe, led by two outside lawyers, involved interviews with 179 people, including accusers, current and former administration employees, and the governor himself. A Belarusian Olympic sprinter who had a public feud with officials from her team at the Tokyo Games said today they made it clear that she would face punishment if she returned home to an autocratic government that has relentlessly stifled any criticism. Waiting to leave Japan to seek refuge in Europe, the athlete said she hopes she can continue her career, but for now, her safety is priority. She criticized the management of her team on social media. She accused officials of hustling her to the airport and trying to put her on a plane back to Belarus. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. An elongated upper-level low across the Bahamas will continue to trigger showers and thunderstorms mainly across the northwest Bahamas, as a surface ridge of high pressure remains anchored across the islands today. Boaters and residents in the northwest Bahamas should remain vigilant due to the threat for waterspout and or funnel cloud activity. There is also the threat for strong thunderstorms and the possibility of localized flooding during heavy prolonged rainfall events. Beachgoers and swimmers in the southeast Bahamas should exercise caution due to the risk of rip currents along east coast beaches. Residents mainly in the central and southeast Bahamas are strongly advised to limit outdoor activities and to remain hydrated due to the high heat indices expected in the triple digits. For the northwest Bahamas, it'll be partly to mostly cloudy, warm and humid, with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms this afternoon through tonight. Showers will be locally heavy and thunderstorms strong to severe at times. Gusty winds and higher seas can be expected in showers and thunderstorms. Winds southeast to south at 10 to 15 knots. Seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. For the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be variably cloudy, hot, and a bit breezy, with isolated showers and thunderstorms possible through tonight. Small craft operators should continue to exercise caution. Winds east to southeast at 15 to 20 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 91 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 75. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:51 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:39. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.